To talk more on nursing care plan, we have Dr. Premila Lee. Madam, can I have you here? She is presently working as nursing superintendent in CMC Vellore, professor of medical surgical nursing and head of surgical nursing department in CMC Vellore, member of national PhD consortium core group, chairman of board of nursing education, and has more than 60 publications in national and international index journals. Over to you, madam, on nursing care plan.
Thank you, sir. Good evening, everyone. I think as I walked into the auditorium, I was listening to Dr. Sunil. One thing that struck me, what he said about the nursing care plan, that no one understands and don't know what's going on. So before I want to start, I want to say that why does that happen? It's mainly because people don't really understand the true meaning of nursing assessment form and the nursing care plan, and people are not trained adequately, and the major factor is lack of time. When you do not have appropriate nurse-patient ratio, expecting them to do a form that takes more time, that is one of the reasons why they do not do it properly. So over time, the documentation has become like a routine rather than individualized. So definitely, nursing care plan is one of the essential part of the nursing practice, if it has to be truly practiced. It provides a framework for patient care. So what is this nursing care plan? It's a standardized, individualized plan. I'm sure many of you have noticed many times the nurses do the recording without really individualizing. It becomes a routine for everybody. So the nursing care plan is initiated so that it becomes more individualized care plan based on the assessment and diagnosis of a nursing problems that has to be carried out by the individual nurse. If it is done correctly, then it could provide direction for individualized patient care and provides a continuity of care. It can become a good communicating tool for patient care among nurses because they will be able to know what has gone on in the previous shifts from the plan. And also, it becomes a proof of care when it is documented. We know that these have a legal implication, so this can become a proof of care, and of course, it becomes a data for audits. So what are the components of nursing care plan? Now, there's a recent study, not very recent, 2012, a systematic review I came across, where they said that they were analyzing the various nursing care plans. So finally, what they concluded was there is no really format that is common or unique to anyone. It varies from place to place. So keeping that in mind, now, whatever the different formats that people use, ultimately, what are the major components that has to be involved in a nursing care plan of five? That is assessment, diagnosis. Now, this is different from medical diagnosis. We use the term nursing diagnosis. What does it mean? At the end of the assessment, the nurse should be able to identify all the problems that the patient need to be addressed. Not only just the physical problems, also the psychosocial problems or any other related issues. So these are the term that we use, nursing diagnosis, ultimately end up with the list of problems or the needs that need to be met for the patient. Of course, the goal to be set for each of these problems to be addressed and appropriate interventions and finally evaluation. So how does the nursing care plan get formulated and what should a nurse do? When the patient gets admitted, we do an initial assessment. Now, that's part of the NABH requirement. So patients do get assessed. In fact, there's a complete assessment should be done at that point so that the people who take care of the patients later will know what it is. It is documented. So the patient gets a complete head-to-foot assessment at the time of admission. And apart from that area specific to their problem, whichever system that they affected, that the specific assessments have to be carried out. Now, apart from that, on a day-to-day, when the nurse sees the patient, has to give importance to the issues of the patient and then identify what are the problems that they have. So for example, if a patient says that they have a pain, then they assess with a pain scale, with a pain score, and then come out with the problem that is pain. So they come out with the, so after that, there's a goal or there is an outcome that they have to plan. So what do they want to do? So the pain is minimized, alleviated. So within how long? So that is to be very, it has to be very specific because your interventions has to be focused accordingly. So the nurse comes out with the interventions according to the level of pain. Now, depending on whether it is just providing a hot water bottle or it is just providing a metacin, and the nurse continues to assess. And as she monitors, if the pain does not change or if the pain does not reduce adequately, then she moves on to the next level of interventions with the order, for example, maybe ask for a morphine or whatever it is. So this is what the nurse is expected to do. Now continuously monitor and change the plan accordingly and until the patient completely is relieved of the pain. So these are some of the just the examples that I've given what the nurse does. So now how do people use it? There are, as I said, there are different types that the people are using. There are different samples that are available. Now, if I recollect, probably 2 years back in our own institution, we had, there is a nurse's record, then we had a nursing care plan, then there were several score sheets came, like fall risk assessment, pain assessment, and so many assessment, and finally the nurses were handling several records together. So we tried to put everything together into one sheet, make it as a part of the day-to-day record so that duplication can be avoided. So this is what something that we came out with. This is just a glimpse of our assessment form. So when the patient gets admitted, the nurse does the complete assessment within the 24 hours. And then after that, we have the nursing care plan, which is incorporated into the nurse's record. This is one component. Now there are several components of the problems or the needs are spelled out in the nurse's records. For example, for pain, now the pain score is incorporated into the plan itself so that the nurse who looks after the patient can quickly note down the score of the patient and then she can plan what to be done. And as she continues to care, whatever is the changes that happens and as the interventions changes, which can be again documented against the modified nursing care and finally the evaluation of the whole process can be done. So this is just an example, but there are other samples which are available, other ways by which people are using it. Just outline to say about patients' needs, problems, outcomes, interventions, and the evaluation to say whether the needs are met or not. Now, if you have an electronic health record, which is, that is the most easiest method, because then you can have a standardized nursing care plans for your patients. So that would really save a lot of your patient staff time because then all the interventions for a particular, because every individual area has a responsibility of developing this nursing care plan very specific to their patient. It can be disease focused and then the nurse who cares for the patient will go through and she will just mark where it is relevant. So ultimately what is very important, the care plan that is made, it should not be just general or it should not be just the common to all patients, all times. It has to be individualized and it has to be patient-centered. So just to recapture, it's important that the nurse has to collect data. Now, not just by history alone, by physical assessment with the lab data. So put everything together. At the end of it, she should be able to analyze and understand what are the problems that needs immediate interventions. And then the beginners, they could even validate the plans that they make. So that becomes a learning exercise for them. And ultimately, the plan that is made must be reviewed periodically so that is on, that they can move forward. So as it is a legal document, it's important that we have to ensure it is accurate, it's clarity, there is completeness, and also it is comprehensive. So how do we move forward? As sir said, it is a problem that everywhere, but there is a way to move forward. We need to practice. I can say that when we introduced plan in a different way, there was a lot of hesitancy and there was, I mean, people were not very comfortable, but I won't say even now that is completely everyone is comfortable, but we are still working towards that to see how to make it better and better. So what makes it perfect is the practice, and we need to continue to learn from resources. I think for the nurses, again, it's important for them to continue to learn so that they can identify, they can improve their assessment skills, and they also can continue to learn new interventions that can be utilized for their own patient. So they need to develop their assessment skill and how to prioritize the needs. And it's important for the leaders, if we could create a template so that could help the nurses to move forward. Thank you.